Hello, I'm Oriana. Welcome to another exciting Tech Talk video brought to you by Zyxel Networks. It's the year 2024 and Wi-Fi 7 has finally been published. With this new milestone in wireless technology, what better time to talk about how Nebula Control Center can assist you in maintaining your wireless network? In this Tech Talk episode, we will discuss how to interpret Wi-Fi Aid to help us identify and resolve wireless issues. Finding out the point of failure for wireless clients can become a stressful job for any local IT. This is because wireless clients need to pass through several network architectures before reaching the internet. Starting from the wireless network, through the wired Ethernet, and all the way up to your internet service provider. And this is where the inspiration for Wi-Fi Aid comes from. By breaking down events associated with failures in these respective architectures, we can identify these failures under three categories. So instead of explaining what each of these categories mean, why don't we try this out on the field? We've just received an email from our employee Janice. It seems that there has been some issues with people accessing the Wi-Fi for a while now. Looks like there's been some reoccurring connection issues on our accounting office. Well, not much to go by from that email. Janice's team should be on the first floor. So let's head on over to our Nebula site, called Zyxel First Floor, and have a look for ourselves. Wi-Fi Aid starts off by providing us with the overall connection problems across your Nebula site. Here, we can already see that problems are already present. It seems that 11 out of 140 clients seem to have experienced some sort of network failure in the past 2 hours. We see that there are 2 failures on the wireless, 5 on the DHCP, and 4 for DNS. Since these are failures in 3 different categories, we can assume that there are at least 3 issues present in the network that are unrelated with each other. After all, you can't have a DHCP issue if your client couldn't connect to the network. Likewise, you can't have DNS issues if your client was never assigned an IP by the DHCP server. When troubleshooting network issues, we either start from the lower OSI layer and work to the top, or the other way around. Both are common practices and is mostly up to personal preference. But for our demonstration, we will be starting from the wireless going up. We start at the failed client's card of our Wi-Fi Aid. Since we're starting our investigation from the wireless layer, we should focus our attention for now on clients with wireless connection issues. We see that the laptop 14 and laptop 56 have completely failed to connect to the network across all connection attempts in the past 2 hours. We know for sure that these are clients who have failed to connect to the network and has made no successful connection due to the default toggle option above. Let's check what specific events have occurred for laptop 14. NCC allows you to quickly check these specific events by clicking on the number of failed connections. Looks like this is a common case of handshake failures. All wireless clients connecting to an AP must undergo a 4-way handshake. In the case of WPA2 Personal, the password entered by the client device is converted into a pairwise transient key, PTK. This PTK is then rehashed into the MIC submitted to the AP for processing. So what happens when our client's Wi-Fi password does not match our AP's? The AP generates its own version of MIC from its own PTK and attempts to match this with the station's MIC. Since they ultimately do not match, the handshake process fails, resulting in the logs we see here. Note that although the process is different, failures in WPA3 negotiations also creates the same set of logs. So is this the case of our users simply entering the wrong Wi-Fi password? Well, not always. There are cases where environment with too much noise can degrade wireless transmission, causing malformed packets to reach between these devices, ultimately also causing handshake failures. So before we make our conclusion, let's have a look at our wireless health. Great! Looks like a pretty healthy wireless network. We can now safely say that these are just ordinary cases where users are trying to access the network with the wrong Wi-Fi password. Well, that's all the time we have for this Tech Talk episode. Like, comment, and subscribe. And we will continue with our Wi-Fi analysis in part 2 of our Wi-Fi 8 episode.
We're Zyxel, and we're your networking ally.